Welcome to Holy Trinity Lutheran Church in Marietta, Georgia, on this Saturday evening, August 1st. We're glad that you are here to worship with us. Please use the comments section to greet one another and enjoy each other's company. I'm Pastor Bonnie. On behalf of Pastor Mark and Chaz and all of our team here, you are welcome to this worship, on this modern worship this evening. We hope that you will have a sense of God's love and mercy here tonight. Whoever you are, whatever you are going through, whatever you've been through, please know that you are loved by God. Let us now sing together.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, King of glory, King above all kings. This is amazing grace, this is unfailing love, take my place, that you would bear my cross. Oh, you lay down your life, that I would be set free. But Jesus, I sing all that you've done for me. Thank you so much to be able to gather together, either at home, at work, in our room, wherever we are in this place, to gather you and to worship you, and to gather together to give you praise and to give you honor. We thank you for that, and we ask your blessings on tonight, and we ask your blessings on each person watching and listening. We just pray that the peace and the presence and the power of your Holy Spirit would give grace and mercy to each of us today. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Please join me in the call to worship. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Thank you.
We come before our gracious God and confess our sin. God of mercy and love, forgive us for turning away from you, for putting other things first in our lives, for the things we've done and the things we've left undone, for not loving you with all our hearts or our neighbors as ourselves. Heal us, forgive us, and strengthen us to walk in the light of your love again. Amen. Jesus Christ is the light of the world, the light no darkness can overcome. In his name, receive the good news that you and all who turn back to God are forgiven, blessed, and renewed to live and love again. Amen. We continue now with our offering. We are very grateful for all the offerings that you have given us. We are in these doldrums of summer. It's in the summer months, typically, when offerings drop down, so we really appreciate your offerings. You can go to holytrinitymarietta.org, and there are plenty of ways to give there. Or if you're a visitor, we ask that you're welcome to give here, but if you don't give to Holy Trinity, please consider giving to a worthwhile ministry. There's a lot of people, a lot of good ministries out there, and a lot of people in need these days. Please give back a portion of what God has first given you. We hear now God's word, first from Psalm 145. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up those who are bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open wide your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. You are righteous in all your ways and loving in all your works. You are near to all who call upon you, to all who call upon you faithfully. A reading from Matthew, the 14th chapter. Now when Jesus heard about the beheading of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion on them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away, and you give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but five loaves and two fish." And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and 2 fishes, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds, and all ate and were filled. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides the women and the children. Abundant grace, mercy, and love are yours from God our Father and our compassionate Savior. Amen. There was a very kind and compassionate woman in her upper 80s, well loved by everyone. Well, one day she was suffering an intense pain, unbearable pain, so she went to see a doctor. Well, the doctor ordered lots of tests, and after several very long hours, the doctor came in the room, pulled up on her computer an X-ray of the abdomen of this woman. And don't forget, this woman was a very kind, compassionate, faithful woman. It kind of felt like we were on an episode of Seinfeld. The doctor dramatically pointed to the X-ray of her abdomen, and with a big smile, she said, "You are full of it." Quite literally, your intestines are full of it. And you could clearly see that from the X-ray. She was full of it. This image has been on my mind as I listen to people discussing current events in the news and speaking about various people as being full of it. I've heard people saying that some media sources are full of it. You can't trust what they say. At the same time that these trying months have been unfolding, our scripture readings have been telling us what God is full of. God is full of truth, love, mercy, and compassion. What are we full of? What are others full of these days? Many of us are full of weariness as this pandemic seems to go on and on and on. Some are filled with anger and frustration at the injustice and violence that we see in videos. Some are filled with grief, with the suffering caused by the pandemic and other losses. And certainly, we have witnessed people full of themselves and their desires, unable to comprehend our common humanity, our need for support, our need to work together on problems at hand, to help each other through this. But thank God, as these months have been passing by, we've also been hearing God's word telling us that God is full of truth, love, compassion, mercy, grace. Today's readings are abundantly full of this. God is full, abounding even with steadfast love, compassion, mercy, and grace. That psalm began with, "The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love." Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works. And we heard an example of this acted out in the gospel reading today. And it's important to note that just prior to this gospel reading, Jesus is rejected, and then he hears about the death of John the Baptist, his cousin, the man who baptized him. It's easy to understand that Jesus withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. He needed some time to grieve, some time to pray. What do you think was filling the mind of Jesus at that time? One can imagine tremendous grief over the violent death of his cousin, perhaps thoughts about his own path to the cross that he was taking. In the midst of this painful time, Jesus notices the crowd and their needs, and Jesus is full of compassion. Compassion in Greek is a deep feeling in your gut, this deep feeling in your gut that compels you to action. Even from his own place of grief and pain, Jesus reaches out with healing hands and healing words and provides what is needed. At the end of the day, the disciples come to him full of concern and tell Jesus, "It's late. Send the people away so they can go buy some food for themselves." After all, they're just being logical, practical. They see this tremendous need of the crowd and the meager means they have to meet their needs. Jesus says, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." The disciples say, "But we can't. All we have is 5 loaves and 2 fish. It's not enough. There's no way what we have would be enough." Jesus says, "Bring it to me." And they offer up to Jesus their meager means. Jesus receives it, looks up to heaven, blesses and breaks the loaves, and gives it to the disciples. And the disciples feed the crowds of thousands. We heard that all were ate and filled. There was more than enough to go around. And the leftovers from the meal filled 12 baskets full. The disciples had looked at the tremendous need, all those people in need, and doubted that they could make a difference. "We have very little, Jesus. What can we do?" They think that what they have to offer is woefully inadequate to make a difference. And Jesus says, "Bring it here. Offer up what you have." In the hands of God, their offering was blessed and multiplied and provided in abundance, more, way more than what was needed. I wonder how often we look at the needs of others and wonder, "What can I do? What I have to offer is not that much." Jesus keeps inviting us to bring what we have, offer it up to God. God blesses it and uses it to show his abounding love and compassion with a world that is sorely in need of it right now. Notice that Jesus doesn't magically feed thousands of people all by himself. Jesus gets the disciples involved. They come together, they work together. This is not Jesus working all alone. The miracle unfolds as the people, the disciples, come together, join in with God's mission to love and care for the world. There's a beautiful example of this in a little girl and her mom, Marley and Ashley. Compassion, that deep feeling in the gut to help those in need, compelled by a little girl and her mom into action. They just started something called Friends Snack Stand, and it's simply a folding table in their driveway. There's a sign with a list of snacks that they have available, brownies, popsicles, lemonade, and other things like that. The food and drinks are free for anyone, but there is a tip jar. If you want to make a donation, All that money goes to a local Lutheran church food pantry to feed hungry people in their community. They advertise this friend's snack stand on social media, and even people from far away are contributing. One small, simple thing is growing into something bigger to feed hungry people. Another example. There are many things that our church is doing to serve people in need. One thing that we do is support our local MUST ministry in multiple ways. MUST Ministries has served over 191,000 meals at 26 sites during this COVID crisis. You can be a part of feeding of thousands in our community by bringing to the church non-perishable food, pasta, canned meats, soup, vegetables and fruit, juice boxes, and other non-perishable food and drink are collected here and delivered to MUST Ministries to feed thousands of meals here in our community. Just a simple way to make a positive difference in our community. And just this week, several bags of handmade hats and prayer shawls were delivered to a hospital here by Monica and David. We need to hear this good news. There are good things happening. People are reaching out with the love and care of Jesus. When we look at the needs in our community, the country, and the world, it's easy to feel overwhelmed. Watching or reading a lot of news, filling your mind with too much news can easily make you feel overwhelmed. One of my seminary professors, Dr. Mary Hess, she taught us about going on a media diet. Yes, stay informed with the news, well-respected news sources, but limit the amount of time that you watch or read the news. Limit the time that you look at Facebook or other media platforms, because what you feed your mind really matters greatly. Feeding our minds with God's word fills us with love, mercy, and compassion that compels us to do something to help our fellow man, woman, and child, and all of creation, really. That woman at the beginning of the sermon, that the doctor said she was full of it, she was treated by the doctor. One important way that made her feel better was to change her diet from processed junk food to having a healthy diet full of food the way God made it, fresh fruits and vegetables and whole grain breads, pastas, and rice. She was no longer full of it like before, but full of good things that kept her feeling full longer. God's word is full of good things, things we all need, full of things the world really needs today, full of love, mercy, and compassion. Compassion that turns us toward our neighbor, compels us to offer up whatever we can to make a difference. God always blesses what we offer to bless others. And in the process, we are blessed to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. For those of us that are here this evening, for those of you that are worshiping with us online, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share a sign of peace. Peace. We continue with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, and all-powerful creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's one and only Son, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. I believe in Jesus, suffered at the hands of Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. 3 days later, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, where he is seated at the right hand of God the Father. And one day he will return to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the one holy church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to give you praise, to sing to you. And we say to you tonight, Lord God, that we trust in you. We rely on you. We place our lives in your hands. And if you're listening tonight, would you pray with me the prayer that Scripture has taught us? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Ready.
May God go ahead of you to guide you, behind you to encourage you, beside you to befriend you, above you to watch over you, and within you to give you God's peace. Amen.